Hello dear children, good afternoon everyone, and once again welcome back you all to the online classes. So as you all know that now we are discussing the sixth unit of your SST part, that is Independence of India. So already in that we have completed the first chapter, that is the India under East India Company. So in that chapter we have learned that how the Britishers acquired the India and also the first war of independence, that is the mutiny of 1857, and we also learned what are the reasons for the failure of the 1857 uprising, because we were not one in that the mutiny of 1857, even though it was considered as the first war for the independence, right? And some part of the India it was participated in that mutiny, and rest of the people they were not participated, and there is no unity among the Indians. There is lack of spirit of the nationalism, and many princes of the different territories they were secretly they were supported for the Britishers, and also there was lack of modern warfare, right? So like, and also the leadership. So these are all the reasons by which we have failed in that the first war of independence, that is the mutiny of 1857. So about this all, how the Britishers, how the India completely gone under the rule of the British. So that all we have learned in the first chapter, and now we are going to start the second chapter of this unit, that is important people on the road to freedom, right? So on the road to the freedom. So just to see, now we all got the, now our India got the freedom, right? So every year on August 15 we celebrate it as Independence Day, because we got the independence on the 15th August 1947. So that from that every year we are celebrating 15th August as the Independence Day, right? So see, to got the freedom, so it is not the perseverance of a single person or the community or any one religion like that. It is not at all the perseverance, the hard work of a single person or a single community. It is the sacrifice of many people. Many communities were participated, many religious, everything. Everybody are participated, and everybody sacrifice innumerably, and then they bring the freedom for us. And now we are all are enjoying with our freedom. That is because of the sacrifice of many people, and among them about few people we are going to discuss. Okay, so now let me begin the chapter, that is important people on the road to freedom. Okay, so see, it is our India was ruled by the Britishers more than a century. Yes, with that exploitation, with that harassment, both the economically as well as politically. So in that harassment, our India was ruled by the Britishers more than a century. So later, many people, many heroes, the real heroes we can say, yes, the many real heroes were emerged during these days, and then they fought for the freedom, and they have their own ideas, their own thought, own their own logics. So to get the freedom, the one way to go, everybody if they move in only one way, might be it was difficult to get the freedom. Of course it was very, they faced a lot of problems, they struggled a lot to give the freedom for us, get free the India. So these social reformers, what they believed that to progress and to get the freedom of India, it was very necessary to shed all the age-old practices. Many age-old practices were there, like the child marriage, as well as the sati, and also there is the abolition for the women education. Yes. So likewise, many age-old practices were there, and also there some of the dogmas. Okay, there our siddhanta. Okay. So likewise, they believe in the traditional methods. These are all. So that age-old practices are there, and some social events were there. Some age-old practices like believing in the in different means. Some religions are there. Means their beliefs will be different. So likewise, according to their beliefs, there some age-old practices will be there. So then they will think that if we want to get the freedom and if we want to get rid of from the Britishers, first they have to shed all the age-old practices, and together everybody together have to fight against the Britishers. Then only it is possible to free the India from their hands. So likewise, they shed all the age-old practices and their dogmas, and then many people were sacrificed in many things, and even they instilled the many things, many thoughts in the Indian people. So likewise, the courage and the fearlessness, education and the perseverance and the sacrifice and the integrity. Okay, and first of all, the love towards their motherland. Because the first thing, what happened? There is the less spirit again among the about the motherland. Yes, the nationalism was not there in the first war of independence. So that firstly we have that the love towards our motherland. So when we love our motherland, then that courage will come, that fearlessness will come, and the perseverance to get free the India. So likewise, they instilled these all the thoughts in the Indians, and finally, many people they have sacrificed innumerably to get free the India, and finally we got the freedom. Yes. So this is all it was to get the freedom. Right. So now we can discuss the social reformers and their contributions towards the independence India. Okay. So now we can discuss about the social reformers. So these social reformers, their aim is to get rid from all the social ills, such as the child marriage, sati, and education for everyone, equality. So this caste discrimination, so among the discrimination among the religious, the discrimination among the caste, discrimination in male and female. So to get rid of all these social ills, this is the aim of these social reformers. So everybody are treated and respected equally. That is the main aim, and there is an advantage of British rule also. That is, they established the Western education in the India, so that from the Western education, so it was able to get ridden social evils. So finally, they abolished many of the social evils. So now we can discuss some of the social reformers and on what fact, on what social evil they were fighting for. So that we can discuss in now. So first one, Rajaram Mohan Roy. So he was the social reformer and he worked towards the eradicating means completely removing. Yes, eradicating means completely removing some of the injustice, social evils, unfair and unjust social customs like sati and child marriage. The Rajaram Mohan Roy was a social reformer and he worked towards eradicating the sati and child marriage. Baby get birth, so that time only slave. But he also fight for the even the women. The female is also having the right towards the inherited property of the parents. So these are all about the contributions of the Rajaram Mohan Roy. And the next one, it is Swami Dayanand Saraswati. He founded the Dayanand Saraswati founded Arya Samaj. Arya Samaj, that means the meaning is noble society. Okay, so the aim of this Arya Samaj, or the which means the noble society, he was founded in the year of 1875. He formed the Arya Samaj. That is the meaning of Arya Samaj is noble society, and he found that in the year of 1875. So it was formed by, who is the founder of Arya Samaj? Yes, it is Swami Dayanand Saraswati. And he formed the Arya Samaj for creating the awareness among the people about this social events and to eradicate all these social events. So this was the aim to form the Arya Samaj, which means the noble society. So its aim is to bring the awareness, is to create the awareness among this all the discrimination and all kind of social customs, and to form the our society as a noble society. So with this aim, they he formed the Swami Dayanand Saraswati formed the Arya Samaj, which means the noble society. So these are the contributions of Swami Dayanand Saraswati. And next we can discuss about Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar. Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar. So he was the social reformer and also the academician, the educationist. So Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, he was the social reformer as well as he was the academician. So he gave the more priority towards the education, that too for the education for women. So he was worked very hard for giving the education for the women. Okay. So on that, and also he worked for the empowerment, the women empowerment, as well as he also proposed the widow remarriage act. The Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, he also proposed the Widow Remarriage Act, Act 15 in 1856. He proposed the Widow Remarriage Act 15 in the year of 1856. So that widow remarriage means widow, means who lost her dignity. So that way, that is we call as the widow. And according to this act, a widow can also she can able to build their life with the dignity, means other dignity. Okay, so likewise, this is what the Widow Remarriage Act. According to this act, the widow can also live with her life with the dignity. So this is the Widow Remarriage Act 15, which was proposed in the year of 1856, and which gave so this is, he also encouraged the women's education. Okay, he, the Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, he also encouraged women's education. And these are all the contribution of the Ishwar Chand Vidyasagar, a social reformer as well as the academician. Okay, these are the contribution. Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan. So he was the social reformer, and he worked hard for the progress and upliftment of the Muslim community. So in the earlier days, the Muslim community, they were also treated without respect, so that to treat them and to progress the Muslim community and to uplift the Muslim community, he was worked very hard, and he convinced them that Western education was important for the progress of the Muslim community, and even he encouraged the women education also, and for this purpose only he found the university, that is Aligarh Muslim University. Aligarh Muslim University.